In this video, you're about to see one simple way to plumb and vent a toilet using just a handful of basic DWV fittings. Keep in mind there are several acceptable ways to vent a toilet, but the purpose of this video is to show you one simple pattern. And another thing, if you'd like to see more examples of how to vent a toilet that aren't discussed in this video, hang out till the end of the video and I'll show you how to get this free toilet venting guide with over 8 venting patterns inside. So let's get started. Here's the basic overview. You're looking at a 4-inch closet flange that connects to a short piece of 4-inch PVC that drops right into a 4x3 closet bend. Closet bend is 4 inches on the inlet and 3 inches on the outlet. Immediately downstream is a Y with 45 that gets sized to local code, and more on sizing vents in just a second. But note, this Y is installed directly under a wall. This allows the toilet's vent takeoff to be vertical, and that's important. So this vent continues up the wall, and it can either tee into the home's existing venting system in many cases, or it can terminate through the roof all on its own. Let's go a little bit deeper into this pattern and start by answering a common question. Does a toilet need to be vented? Yes, codes require toilets to be vented. In fact, any trap or trapped fixture needs to be vented, including fixtures with internal traps like toilets. 901.2.1 of the IPC says it like this. Traps and trap fixtures shall be vented in accordance with one of the venting methods specified in this chapter. So the venting method that you're seeing here in this example is considered conventional venting. That's when a plumbing fixture is vented with its own individual vent. An individual vent is a single pipe that vents a plumbing fixture's trap. Keep in mind there are other venting methods. There's common venting, there's wet venting, there's circuit venting to name a few. But the purpose of this video is to just demonstrate a simple individual vent. Okay, moving along, let's talk about how to size a toilet's vent. The size of a toilet's vent depends on your local plumbing code. The two main codes in the U.S. are the IPC and the UPC. In the IPC, a toilet's individual vent is sized at 1.5 inches. This is based off 906.2. So if that's you, you can install a 3x3x1.5 Y with 1.5 inches Street 45 to vent the toilet. Now to those in the UPC, toilet vents are sized at a 2-inch minimum. So if that's you, you can go with a 3x3x2 Y with a 2-inch Street 45 to vent your toilet. I'll also quickly mention in UPC jurisdictions, it's common to see one toilet in the home plumbed with a 3-inch vent or even sometimes a 4-inch vent. And the purpose of this oversized vent is to satisfy the UPC's aggregate venting requirement. Aggregate venting is a topic for another video, but if you want to see an example of a toilet plumbed with a 3-inch vent, again, hang out to the end of the video because our free toilet venting guide includes an example with a 3-inch vent. Moving along, I'll answer another important question. How far can a vent be from a toilet? The answer to this question depends on your local plumbing code. The toilet's trap arm, also referred to as the fixture drain, is the pipe between the trap in the vent. If you're in the IPC, there is no limitation in length for the toilet's trap arm. That's right, no limitation. That means your fixture drain can have an unlimited distance. Keep in mind your toilet still needs a vent, but your trap arm can be as long as you need it. Now on the other hand, if your plumbing code is the UPC, they're not as generous. In the UPC, the toilet's trap to vent distance is limited to 6 feet. And here's how the UPC wants this measurement taken. You'll measure from the face of the closet flange along the center line of the pipe to the inner edge of the vent opening. So those in UPC jurisdictions, make sure this distance is 6 feet or less. Additionally, if you plumb your toilet with a 4-inch toilet drain, the UPC still limits your trap to vent distance to 6 feet. All right, so let's talk about the toilet's drain size. Regardless of your plumbing code, the minimum drain size for a toilet is 3 inches. That means all this can be 3 inches. This could be a 4x3 closet flange and a 3-inch 90 and still be up to code. In the free guide, you'll see several examples of toilets plumbed entirely in 3 inches. Last thing I'll quickly mention because some folks may be wondering, how many toilets on a 3-inch drain? This answer varies based on local code, so check yours, but here's the UPC's take. No more than 3 toilets are allowed on any 3-inch horizontal drain. The moment a 4th toilet connects, that horizontal drain needs to increase to 4 inches. But that also assumes you don't exceed the max DFU load permitted by Table 703.2. No more than 35 DFUs or drainage fixture units can connect to a 3-inch horizontal drain. A toilet is 3 DFUs if it flushes 1.6 gallons or less. Older toilets that flush over 1.6 gallons are 4 DFUs. So in the UPC, don't exceed 3 toilets and don't connect more than 35 DFUs to any 3-inch horizontal drain. On the other hand, the IPC has a different take and doesn't have this same 3 toilet limitation. Instead, you're limited to a maximum of 42 DFUs connected to a 3-inch horizontal pipe sloped at a 1/4 inch per foot. This assumes that pipe is either the building drain, a branch of the building drain, or the building sewer. If the pipe is a horizontal branch connecting to a stack, you're limited to 20 DFUs on a 3-inch pipe. What about 4 inches? How many toilets on a 4-inch drain? The UPC allows a whopping 216 DFUs on a 4-inch building drain sloped at a 1/4 inch per foot. The IPC also allows 216 DFUs. Again, this assumes the pipe's a building drain, a branch of the building drain, or the building sewer. All right, so that wraps up this basic pattern to plumb and vent a toilet. Keep in mind there are other ways to vent a toilet that aren't covered in this video. And if you want to see some more examples, I put together this free guide with over 9 different toilet venting patterns inside. These are easy to follow 3D diagrams that show you how all the pieces fit together. Each fitting is labeled, and you'll see drain and vent sizes for both major plumbing codes in the U.S., the IPC and the UPC. Just click the link in the description of this video. You'll be brought to this page on our website. Just put in your email address, and a minute or two later, we'll send you the free guide with the PDF file. If for some reason you don't see our email after a few minutes, check your spam folder or your promotions tab if you're in Gmail. Or you can always type in the link in your browser if you need to. The page is hammerpedia.co/vent. Thanks for watching and have a great day.